All right, so road running. I want to talk about why I love road running so much. And it's funny because my channel is called The Lone Trail, right? And I do love trail running too. In fact, I probably do love trail running even a little bit more than I love road running. But I want to talk about the differences a little bit and why I like road running, and I guess also why I like trail running, and why at the moment I'm doing just road running races. And for all of 2019, I think most of my races, if not all, are road races. And yeah, let's talk about why that is. And yeah, let's just talk about why I love running. Let's do it. So I love all kinds of running, honestly. Anything from short sprints to long ultra marathons. As a kid, I used to sprint a lot. In our little neighborhood, I used to almost like arrange these contests with other kids where I would like time their running, and of course I would be like the fastest. I was always the fastest, which I guess maybe tells me something about my abilities. Maybe I'm a more natural born sprinter. I sort of hope not, because I'm more into the endurance running. But who knows? This channel is called The Lone Trail, right? You would think that I would just do trail races, right? And as I started out with running, I guess a few years ago, when I started getting interested in it, I always loved running. And you can check out my video about my background in running. I'll put a link to it there. I think I did probably think that I was gonna like trail running more than road running at the beginning. But as I started training more and more, I was forced to also run on the roads, obviously, because of practicalities. Sometimes it's just easier to head out on a road run from home rather than having to find trails or drive to some trailhead or whatever. And so road running became a natural part of my training, and I started liking it more and more. And at this point, I would even go as far as to say that I'm 50-50 almost when it comes to enjoying road running and enjoying trail running. Here's the thing about road running that I really, really like, okay? I'm a numbers guy, okay? I love the numbers. I love Jack Daniel's distance running formula. I did a review of that book. I'll put a link to it here. I'm reading it again now, and I love that book because it's all about equations and percentages of max. And you know, okay, if your oxygen consumption at different submaximal speeds, and you can sort of see the correlation, the mathematical correlation between the different times in the marathon and your VO2 max and your running economy, and you can plot these curves, call it like an aerobic profile, where you can see your economy curve, how much oxygen you use at different speeds, etc. It's just very measurable, and running in general is a very measurable sport. I mean, how do you measure football success, a football player? Well, maybe about how many goals he or she has made in his or her career, or how efficient they are, how tactical they are. Perhaps it's difficult to measure how good a football player is, but with a runner, there's no question. It's like, how fast do you run a 10K? Well, 50 minutes, okay, 50 minutes, you're a 50-minute person. Have you gone sub 30 for the 10K, right? That's almost like then you're in the class of your own when you go sub 30. It's very black and white. It's just either you run this time or you don't. And I love that. So I guess that's one of the reasons why this year, I don't know if you've seen my video where I talk about my 2019 races, I'll put a link to it here. It's pretty much all road racing. And the reason I'm loving it at the moment is because I want to see where I'm at, right? I'm passionate about running. I'm ambitious. I have high ambitions. I don't know if it's possible. Do I have the genetics? Can I do it? I'll try, but I don't know. And so in order to sort of see my progression over the years and how my running is doing, I like to look at metrics. So I use my watch, the Garmin Forerunner 630. I always, pretty much, I would say 99% of the time, seriously, I run with a heart rate monitor. I love looking at my heart rate. I love looking at my pace. I love looking at Strava, and there's a Strava link in the description if you want to follow me on Strava. I love looking at Strava to analyze my workouts, see how my pace to heart rate ratios, different ratios of different sorts. I would love to do more metabolic testing. Like, if I could go in and do like a VO2 max test every 3 months or every 6 months, and like a lactate test. I really do want to get like a lactate measuring system, actually, to measure lactate when I'm training. that would be really very interesting to sort of dial in that threshold pace, etc. And so yeah, so you know, as you can see, I'm super passionate about all the different metrics, and road running just lends itself more to measurement, right? When you're doing trail running, the terrain is very much up and down. It's technical, maybe sometimes technical, sometimes not. So to sort of to look at two different trail races and try to compare them, it's pretty difficult because there's so many different profiles. But if you're looking at something like New York City Marathon versus Berlin Marathon versus Boston Marathon versus Fukuoka Marathon or something like that, different big marathons, sure, there are differences in the profile, and Boston goes down a little bit. It's more of a downhill thing, like a slight downhill kind of thing. And Berlin is very flat, etc. But it's easier to sort of look at the different performances and grade them in relation to each other. So basically, when I ran my first half marathon last summer, my second half marathon in September, and I did a huge improvement, but of course the second one was actually a road race, whereas the first one was not. So I did a 133 something, was it 38? 133.38, I don't remember. Something like that in Oslo half marathon in September 2018. And I have another one coming up now in May, another half marathon in Göteborg. So coming up in a couple of months. I want to see if I can go faster, right? So I've done more training. I'm building up again. My training hasn't been ideal over the last few months, to be honest. I was sick a couple of times as well. But okay, I'm starting that build up now, really, really upping mileage. And let's see if I can go sub 130. I think I can go sub 130 because, you know, Oslo has a lot of hills, whereas Göteborg is more flat. So I should already probably be able to go sub 130. But can I go sub 125? I mean, that would be ridiculously insane if I could. I hope, but I probably don't think I can go that fast at the moment. But then, of course, in a year, I do expect to go sub 125. And in 2 years, I certainly hope I can go sub 120, etc. Right? Can I ever go sub 110? In my dreams, yes. In reality, perhaps, probably not. I don't know. It's difficult to say. But this is the appeal of road running. This sort of, you can just plot your times and you can measure yourself against yourself very easily. And not only that, but measure yourself against others. You know that when you're running a 110 half marathon, you are essentially sub-elite. You can essentially go to any half marathon and you'll know that you'll be able to, you know, maybe get up there in top 10, right? Depending on the place. And that's something that you can't do with a half marathon, with the trail running. And of course, as you get into ultra races, especially on trails, there are so many other factors as well, like weather. I mean, weather is always a factor, but more so in a long race, and nutrition, and it's just so long that so many other factors play a part. It's difficult to sort of put two performances up against each other or measure your progression. So anyway, that's it. I love both trail and road. One thing that I also love about roads is that this adventure kind of thing, just like in the trails, you head out on an adventure, but it's more of like a, you meet people, you meet more people when you're running on the roads. It's more social in that sense. You can run from city to city and you can see, you go through neighborhoods, you go through residential areas, you look into people's gardens, you see how they live. And then you get into, you know, a beautiful city, or you come out of the city, you go into a beautiful remote area, but you're on the road, and it's just like, it's a monotonous kind of thing. Road running is more monotonous than trail running, but I like that. I like the sort of meditation aspect almost of just, it's just you and the road and you're just moving, and it's very consistent. So I do like that. But of course, as I've said a thousand times now, I do love trail running as well. Certainly. I mean, the variety, the communion with nature, it's almost never boring. Road running can get boring sometimes, but then I'll just put on a podcast or something. Whereas trail running, never boring, always interesting. Let me know in the comments what you think. Like, do you like road running better than trail running, or vice versa? Do you like both, like me? What about the track? I love the track. It's almost like a laboratory where you go to do specific work. So they're all good. All the different types of running is good. I like it all. Yeah, at the moment, road running seems to be a fascination of mine that I intend to pursue alongside my trail running, of course. Thanks so much for being subscribed to this channel. And if you haven't, please click the subscribe button. I would love to have you as a subscriber. I talk about running, as you've probably gathered by now. And give it a like if you like the video. And you know, just the fact that you're watching the video, especially if you're liking and commenting as well, it helps rate the video up so that I'll get more views and more subscribers and that we can grow this channel together. Because it's really a communal effort. It's me and you guys, and we're a community, the Lone Trail community, and we're all off on that lone trail, but we're talking about it here together. So it's a kind of a paradox, like a community of lonely runners. All right. Thanks so much for watching. Have a great day. Bye.